Hello, my name is Brent Barnes. I'm the CEO and Managing Director for LBT Innovations, and happy to be here giving you this update today. Normal disclaimers apply, being a listed company. Look, I like starting with our mission because I think it kind of sets the context of where we operate and what we're trying to achieve. We're really here to disrupt microbiology, and we do that through intelligent automation, specifically a really unique AI platform. And we're doing that to improve workflow practices for our customers. And our customers are laboratories. And so, you know, straight away, you can see the space we operate is microbiology. What we're doing is that we're disrupting it through intelligent automation, and we're doing that to benefit our customers, who are laboratories all around the world. So that's kind of the space that we operate. I mentioned we're an AI platform, so the fundamental IP or the intangible assets really around what we do are all around this imaging and machine vision platform technology. And so we've already built the instrument. We've already delivered a number of the apps that I'll talk about during the presentation. You know, importantly, we're in sales. So I think, you know, as you're considering LBT Innovations as an investment thesis, think, you know, we're not early stage. We're at the point where we have gone through all of the validation of the technology. We've got distribution partners in place. We're commercializing the product, and we are generating sales. Not only that, we recently announced some blue sky with respect to a product pipeline. So I'll talk about that through the presentation. So back on to the market. Clinical microbiology. You know, it's a discipline that hasn't had a lot of innovation for many, many years. In fact, over 100 years. The Petri dish, which you can see on the screen, was invented about 120 years ago, and every lab around the world manages these kind of Petri dishes. And what's important here is that it's an application that is growing. So it's growing around 6%-7% on an annualized basis. And there are not enough staff. There are not enough microbiologists or scientists that are going through the university systems and are in laboratories. So we've got this kind of climate whereby in the U.S. at any one time, 10% of microbiology jobs are vacant. And that is compounded by the fact, you know, you've got a skills shortage, and that drives up labor rates. So, you know, these kind of skilled resources are around $150,000 per annum in terms of a salary. And so, you know, that's the kind of overall market dynamic that we're considering. And of course, we saw this as an opportunity a long time ago, about 10 years ago. And we thought, wouldn't it be fantastic to provide automation in a discipline that, as I mentioned, hasn't had a lot of innovation? And so what we thought would be a great idea is to automate culture plate reading. And so that's what we've done. We've trained an algorithm to interpret colony growth on a Petri dish. And you can see a picture of the Petri dish down the bottom of the screen. And the image next to that is kind of a representation of that digitized image. And so that's what our algorithm sees. And our algorithm is able to differentiate between various colonies that grow. So it's not just looking at the various dots or the bacteria. We're able to differentiate between the different types of bacteria that are on the plate. And that's really important. But really, what the benefit here is for our customers is the ability to make a primary clinical diagnosis. And there are many AI platforms that exist that identify points of interest, but they don't make decisions autonomously. And that's what this instrument does. And for our customers, it means that anywhere between 60%-85% of their workflow is automatically removed. And so the picture on the right is our APAS Independence, our automated plate assessment system. What happens in the lab is that these canisters come out of the incubator, and the technologist goes to the instrument, loads it up with plates, starts a session, and then they walk away. And what happens then is that the plates move from the input module through the imaging station and then to the output module. And so a photo is taken, an algorithm is run, and then a real-time result is determined by the instrument. And so for all of those plates that don't have growth or don't have significant growth, they're automatically discarded out of the workflow. There's no touching of the plate. There's no manual entry required by the scientist, leaving just the the positive plates that require some identification and antibiotic susceptibility testing later on. So that's kind of what the instrument does. And that's where we're looking to disrupt and bringing digital microbiology to labs all around the world. And we do that through through partners and some pretty sizable partners being Thermo Fisher and Beckman Coulter, who I'll talk about later on. Importantly, this thing works. The technology works. It's gone through all of the clinical trials. We've got the regulatory clearances. There's no ambiguity about whether this is, you know, kind of still in development or not. We are generating sales and the product works and is in market. In addition to that, early this year in January, we acquired our joint venture company. So Clever Culture Systems is the commercial name of the business bringing this product to market. And we did that really at the ideal time. We have full operational control of the joint venture now, and that's really positive. At a time where we're starting now to generate sales traction, and it really just simplifies the structure. 100% of proceeds obviously come to us being 100% owners of Clever Culture Systems at this point. In terms of the technology development, I really want to make it clear here that the technology is validated, it's proven, it's cleared, and it's in the market. It's absolutely taken us longer than we expected and cost more than we expected, but we're at the exciting point, I think, again, from an investor's perspective, to have a look at how much this technology has been de-risked. And we're now into that commercialization phase of the maturity. But you can see it's been a long journey. And, you know, we've gone through the various regulatory clearances. We've validated the technology works. We've expanded the technology. And really where we're seeing our future being is to provide automated plate reading for all labs all over the world, including the smaller labs, the medium labs, and the larger labs. And look, just focusing on, I'm not going to talk about the massive market. I'm going to be really specific about the market opportunity in the countries that we've launched. And so we've launched here in Australia, the US, the UK, Germany, and France. And we've done that. And our strategy has always been to appoint commercial partners to be our arms and legs. Brand reputation is so, so important. No one's heard of us, and we're a small company here based in Adelaide in Australia. And having that brand reputation, the sales force, the trust of the likes of both Thermo Fisher and Beckman Coulter, who are huge companies and well-respected by our customers, is absolutely critical. And so the way that the revenue model works here is that the instrument sells at $300,000. So that's the CapEx for the physical instrument. And then there's an annual software license of $30,000. And that's for the apps. That's for these analysis modules that does all the interpretive software. And so, you know, we kind of look and sell these typically on a five-year service contract or incorporating service. But the useful life is anywhere from 7 to 10 years. But for the modeling purposes, call it 5 years. And that's where you kind of get that customer value of being around $450,000 over that five-year time period. And then if you look at the market segmentation, where we're looking at, 13,000 labs globally, but 2,000 labs or thereabouts in the markets that we've launched. And because we've been doing this now for a few years, we launched literally at the time when COVID hit, which unfortunately just shut our customers out of the market, shut us out of the market from getting into the customers. That was a challenge coming out of that challenging environment. And on the back of appointing, Thermo Fisher at the end of the last year, we are now in 2022 calendar year, really seeing the commercial traction building. And that's, I think, what this graph demonstrates in a really powerful way. So we've been at it for a little while. Obviously, COVID hit and affected our ability to get into labs. We were still able to appoint our channel partners in Beckman Coulter and Thermo Fisher. Thermo Fisher was at the very end of 2021, by the way. And we've moved into calendar year 2022 with seven sales, five of those to Thermo Fisher after about 6 months after they were appointed. So that really kind of demonstrates commercial traction in our single largest market. being in the US. And then we had a couple of sales direct with Albany Medical Center and the LADR group more recently in Gischtadt in Germany. So you can kind of see we're building the momentum. We have product market fit and we are making sales on a global basis. And that's really important when considering, does the technology work? Yes. Have we got channel partners to get the technology to market? Yes. Are we making sales? Yes. Do we want to generate more sales? Obviously, the answer to that is yes, but we have the building blocks in place, we believe, to really start moving forward on that commercial momentum path. And look, we announced recently an update to our product pipeline, and this is very much in response to the positive traction that we've had in the market. And so I mentioned this is a $300,000 bit of kit. And so that's in line with other similar pieces of equipment within microbiology laboratories, but really focused on those medium to large labs. And so what we've contemplated here is a strategy where we're reusing all of the investment in our core IP. And as I said before, the IP and where the smarts of this technology is all around the imaging platform, which we control, and the algorithms that we've developed. We've spent over $30 million already investing in that product or that core group of IP. And so what we want to do is really maximize the value already spent to do two things, expand into new markets and to also expand in existing markets. And we do that by going into non-clinical applications, and we do that by having a hardware platform that's at a cost point that is much lower, which opens up the existing market for us. So the APAS Pharma, the microbial quality control, specifically is looking at clean room monitoring. So imagine drug companies, they manufacture drugs in a clean room. And this is ideal for APAS, by the way. You think about a clean room is meant to be clean. Majority of the time, it is clean. But importantly, as part of both a quality control and a quality assurance process to release the drug manufacturing batches, you've got to make sure that your environmental characteristics are compliant. And that's where APAS comes in. So the need here is quality control, visibility and traceability. And APAS provides that much better than the current standard practices and is able to provide autonomous decision-making. So we have both improved quality control and we also have improved efficiency from a labor perspective, a really exciting new application of the technology. And remember, we're using our existing hardware platform. So this is, we've got the iPhone, if you like, and now we're developing the app for the iPhone. Or in our case, APAS Independence is the instrument and we call them analysis modules. So moving to the corporate overview, kind of highlighting the graph and acknowledging that's not a great trend. What is, a great data point across here are the milestones that we've achieved. And there's been a few, but I've picked out the major ones here that I think are really important because they do demonstrate fundamental growth from a business perspective that clearly isn't reflected in a valuation from a share price perspective. So I've spoken about all of these, appointing Thermo Fisher as our exclusive US distributor at the very end of 2021 was really critical. Getting 100% controls of our joint venture, simplifying that structure. Thermo Fisher getting positive traction in the US market, ordering 5 instruments. And we've now sold a couple more, so we're up to 7 in this calendar year. And then announcing this new product strategy gives investors some thought into where we're going to take this company from a technology standpoint. Really exciting, with interest from partners to help us along that growth journey. And so my final slide here is saying, look, I really like this quote. There is no better time to be in microbiology diagnostics. And I truly believe that. We can't, you look at the US, 10% of microbiology jobs are vacant. Their labor rates have increased dramatically. About $150,000 is the average salary for a medical technologist in the United States today. It is ripe for automation. Our customers are requiring, coming to us, wanting to have automation for their labs. And so, look, we have this vision. We have this plan. We want to disrupt microbiology markets, and we want to become the leader. We're not the leader today. But in our view and our vision is we want to become the market leader in intelligent microbiology over coming years. And we do that through getting the right commercial arrangements in place, which we've started to do that. We've already started generating commercial traction. The technology itself already validated. We expect to have multiple products come off this, and I've mentioned some of those already, with an increased market opportunity. So look, we think we're at a point where we've very much turned a corner in 2022 calendar year on the commercialization side, coming off the back of COVID. And we're entering an exciting phase regarding the maturity of our technology, with the right partnerships in place to really start scaling this business to ultimately become the market leader in the space that we operate. Thank you.